The tight turns of Pimlico are up next on the Triple Crown Trail. We go to Pimlico for the 2024 Preakness. It's a Grade 1 stakes, Saturday, May the 18th, a mile and 3/16, a 16th of a mile shorter than the Kentucky Derby. Got some updated news for you on a Friday morning. We've got a new morning line after the scratch of Muth. Muth, of course, the morning line favorite when they drew the field earlier this week. He was scratched. We'll take a look at that. Also, the pace of the race after the scratch of Muth. The sloppy track, who does that benefit if the rain comes in on Saturday? And also, some stride data. Let's take a look at the latest Preakness news for Friday, May the 17th. It's Black Eyed Susan's Day, the day before the Preakness. New morning line is out, and you've got Mugatu at 20-1. Uncle Heavy at 20-1, Catching Freedom now 7-2, The Scratch of Muth, and then Mystic Dan at 8-5, your Kentucky Derby winner. Seize the Gray now 12-1, Just Deal at 12-1, and then 9-2 on Tuscan Gold, 3-1 on Imagination. I think Tuscan Gold's probably going to be closer to 7-2, and Imagination right around 7-2 overall for the Preakness Stakes. But I think Mystic Dan is going to be the favorite, especially with a chance of some rain moving in on Saturday. Now, there really is a tale of two races here with the pace. You've got three horses that really don't have a lot of speed in Catching Freedom, Tuscan Gold, and Uncle Heavy. Then you've got the possibility of a lone speed horse. Last year we saw a wire-to-wire winner in National Treasure, trained by Bob Baffert, came in from Santa Anita, and guess what? This year we have a lone speed again. Imagination comes in, 6 starts, 2 wins, 4 seconds, trained by Bob Baffert, comes in from the Santa Anita Derby, running a tough race, losing in the final strides last time out. Now, the stride data was available for the Kentucky Derby. What this measures is the length of the stride and the frequency of the stride. And what we're going to do is compare the most recent run of these horses with the winner of last year's Preakness. Now, last year, National Treasure had a 7.28 stride length, and the frequency is 2.32. So some of the top contenders that are near that this year, we've got Mystic Dan, who fits right in there, 7.27 for stride length, and then also Tuscan Gold right there in stride length. Frequency rise a little bit more. Remember, slower frequency is longer strides, and kind of a quicker rotation is usually horses that can be a little bit more agile. So we'll see. It kind of worked. Mystic Dan had a similar stride length to last year's Kentucky Derby winner. So Mystic Dan and Tuscan Gold are two horses to watch. Now, if you look at it, Imagination, a shorter stride length, could have a little bit of concerns about going a mile and a quarter. And then also Catching Freedom, a longer stride, but he doesn't quite turn it over quite as much. So we'll see what turns out here. I do think it's some good data to see as we get more database. Of course, this is just the second year with the stride data, with the GMX data available from Equibase. Now, the first turn leader, Mystic Dan, I think overall he's going to be back. His three best races are coming from off the pace. The last three races out, of course, his career high buyer speed figure was in the Southwest Stakes when he caught a sloppy track, and there's a 65% chance of rain on Saturday and maybe even a late afternoon shower. Now, Mystic Dan comes in off 100 buyer in the Kentucky Derby. No official workout since the Kentucky Derby. He's been galloping over the track pretty much daily at Preakness and then late last week at Churchill Downs. Another horse galloping daily is Tuscan Gold. He's got a maiden win at Gulfstream Park. Chad Brown, 2 Preakness wins, and looking for his third here with Tuscan Gold. Tuscan Gold going to be right around 7-2. Now, Catching Freedom seems to be coming out of the Derby, 14-day turnaround, has a lot of energy, was a little bit shuffled further back in the Derby. I think with the smaller field and a softer pace, he'll be closer. And I do think a wet track benefits Catching Freedom, as he seems to be jogging forwardly in the morning. Of course, in the Risen Star, he caught a sloppy track, ended up losing that race late to Sierra Leone. But Catching Freedom, very consistent, a win at Churchill Downs, a win at Oaklawn Park, and a win at the fairgrounds in the Louisiana Derby, catching Freedom by Constitution, ridden by Flavian Prott. Now, imagination, 6 starts, 2 wins, 4 seconds, a lot of speed. If you notice, first and second call, he's always up on the pace or on the lead. Question is, can he get that mile and a 3/16? Plus, he's a little bit slower on some of the speed figures, but he's by Into Mischief. And overall, I do like the fact that he's got some grit, really dug in against Stronghold, dug in the San Felipe, dug in an allowance race against My Moon, who is a very highly ranked contender this spring out west. Now, big questions as you're starting to handicap this race. Looks like it's going to rain on Saturday, sloppy track. Mystic Dan and Catching Freedom, I think, will move up a little bit on a sloppy track. Maybe Tuscan Gold sees the gray stretching out from that Pat Day mile. And does he show speed to help set it up for his entry mate, Just Steal, in this race? And I do think Catching Freedom is one to watch. I thought his Derby was a pretty solid performance, and I don't think he needs to be as far back as he has been in his last two races. So those are some of the comments here. Now, 65% chance of rain on Saturday, maybe even overnight Friday into Saturday. Afternoon showers possible. Going to be a little bit cooler and some wet weather. Definitely some rain at some point on Saturday, maybe even in the morning. So with that in mind, my top selection is still going to be Imagination, but Tuscan Gold is my second choice. If it comes up really sloppy, then I'm liking Catching Freedom a little bit. I think he moves up on a sloppy track, a big effort, and I just like the way his stride and the energy level he had coming into the Derby, and I think he could take advantage of a moderate pace if Imagination can't go the mile and 3/16. Now, Mystic Dan, 100 buyer speed figure fits. He's got a big win in the slop. His best race ever was in the slop. Quick turnaround, but a low price. So, you know, if you got him at 18-1 in the Derby, I'm not sure you want 8-5 here in the Preakness. Those are just some of the thoughts on Mystic Dan. Now, they do have a wager called Black Eyed Susan Preakness Double. If you're watching this on Friday, I'm going to be going with Recharge and Gunsong in the Black Eyed Susans on Friday. And then on Saturday, I'm going to take Imagination and Tuscan Gold on the back half of that Black Eyed Susan's double. That is Friday and Saturday. If you're betting on Saturday only, I'm going to go with Imagination and Tuscan Gold in my doubles and pick threes and win wagers. Now, the post positions have been drawn. Moose scratched. Mystic Dan, the new favorite. Tuscan Gold down to 7-2 and Imagination 3-1 for the Preakness Stakes. Don't forget, if you want the tip sheet, it comes out Saturday morning. Look for it in the link below or in the description. Sign up, get Belmont picks, Travers Day picks, some of the big racing days this summer, like Indiana Derby Day and other big days. And who is your Preakness pick for 2024? Leave a comment. Smash that like button. Who will it be? A sloppy track? Can Mystic Dan win the second jewel of the Triple Crown? Dwayne Lucas says people have opinions, horses have the facts.